टू चैनल टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ फॉरेंसिक मेडिसिन द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द लॉ एंड मेडिसिन इज द फॉरेंसिक फर्स्ट इज द फॉरेंसिक मेडिकल एंड सेकेंड इज द मेडिकल jurisprudence. So what is forensic or legal medicine? It is the application of the medical knowledge in administration of justice. So the knowledge of the medicine applied in the justice, that is law, is nothing but forensic legal medicine. Example, we can take the medical knowledge in deciding the cases of injuries, murders, suicide, accidents, sexual offenses and poisoning. That is the medical aspects of laws. That is nothing but the medical aspects of laws. And the medical jurisprudence is, first, juris means law, prudence means knowledge. So the law knowledge is required for this. That is the legal responsibilities of the physician or and the patient relationship. The legal aspects of practice of the medicine is this medical jurisprudence. And the example is medical negligence cases, consent, rights and duties of the doctor, serious professional misconduct and also medical ethics. So what is forensic pathology? The applications of the effects of violence or unnatural diseases, unnatural deaths. That is in the application of the violence related with the treating of doctor. Example, determining the cause, the manner of death in the case of violence, suspicion, unexplained, unexpected, sudden or medically unattended deaths. So what are medical ethics? The medical ethics is a moral principle guiding in the medical profession with each other and also patient's state. So we should always behave in a well manner with patients and also with other doctors. The medical etiquette, what it says is conventional laws of courtesy between the members of the profession. That is, what is this medical ethics saying? This, we should always not criticize or denigrate other professional ability of another doctor while dealing with the patients. So we should always not disrespect other doctors while treating a specific patient. And also this medicine is a branch which deals with the crimes, that is against humans, in which the examination and evidence are required. So the doctor should be, the aim of this forensic medicine is to find out the truth behind the unexplained deaths. So it's judicial investigation, civil and crime cases. So the doctor is required to appear as the witness in the court of the law. So the doctor will be the chief source of the evidence on which the legal decisions are made. So the cause of sudden death, like authorities completely depend on the medical evidence establishing the cause of death, and in case of accident to determine the blame. So actually the doctor plays the major role in forensic medicine. The doctor is called to testify. So first, what the doctor should do? First, he should ordinary witness who saw the incident. First, he should call the person who has seen the incident, and as a medical practitioner who treated the patient, and you need to find who have treated the patient, and as an expert who provided opinion on matter of science, and you also need to find out that who has given the matter. So after getting all this, he can find out whether this is a crime or the person died naturally. So the doctor should not become partisan, that is, he should not always involve in a wrong way, always should provide correct information. He should present truth as he sees it, adding nothing, withholding nothing or distorting nothing. So he should not add anything to it. He should always say truth to the court people to follow the medical ethics. Should not be the influenced by emotional consideration. So he should not get influenced by any emotions of patients or relatives or any other person. Always say truth to the court. And doctor must be honest, confident, depend on honesty and success. So the medical or legal aspects of any case must be secondary to the life-saving treatment of the patient. Vagueness and theory have no place in the forensic medicine. The burden of presenting medical facts, opinions is best possible way depends on the doctor. So the forensic pathologist testifies the fact issues like cause, manner of death, rather than the ultimate issue of guilt or innocence. So what are required to become a good forensic pathologist is good command of language, clear presentation of the situation, ability in expressing the opinion are necessary for the success of medical witness, need both writing skills and also ability to express in the courtroom, being examined by the trained lawyer. So a trained lawyer always helps us to do the right things to provide to the court. The doctor should avoid talking more and also talking too soon and talking to wrong persons. So always doctors should be patient and provide the correct information. The medico-legal expert, not a detective. So actually everyone thinks the forensic like detective persons, but doctors are not detectives. They only use the knowledge of their subject to help the police. He helps the police to solve the crime case. So should be very careful while examining the living people. So always be careful while treating patients. And three things for the success of this forensic medicine is the power of observation, wide range of exact knowledge, and power of deduction, and the power of imagination also essential when no facts to be seen. So sometimes we also need to imagine the correct case, what has happened, because sometimes there are no true facts back of them. So actually to become good forensic practitioner, we need the experience, common sense, willingness, and also essential for the forensic. So the three steps are caution, foresight, and wisdom. A next example, if some victim is come from homicidal attack. What is homicidal attack? It is nothing but killing a person. If one person kills the other person, then we need with the it absorbs like peritonosis, abdominal injuries, and surgery should be certified. But the doctor sometimes may say false that this is just the surgery but not homicidal attack. But saying like this, see, should be certified homicide but not as surgery, because sometimes this doctor's failure may make difference between the life and death or freedom and imprisonment of the suspected person. So if the doctor says false that it is because of surgery instead of homicidal attack, then the wrong innocent person gets affected and the murderer may escape from the punishment. So he will escape and the innocent person will be attacked. So always say truth in the court regarding the attacks of persons, not by saying it as surgery. So sometimes there are variations, so absolute proof is not always possible. So it is really very hard work of a forensic practitioner to find out whether it's a suicide case or murder case or natural death. So it should be able to provide the photographs. So by this it can be cleared. Always keep photographs, maps, diagrams, charts, x-rays, skeletals, models, slides, and tapes. So always it's important to put the record backside to show whether it's a murder or suicide or any other cases. So skills are needed. What skills are needed is clinically we need to ability to say the history and precision in recording findings, that is able to say the accurate findings, and also ability to present the findings in a clear, concise, correct and meaningful manner, because the correct and clear records are only useful to find out this. And the attitude should be proper respect to the patient and always maintain record findings. To learn this subject, students can attend the courts and follow the proceedings and note the questions and replies there. So all medical students are suggested to go to court and follow this to get replies, questions, and practice studies. So doctors should avoid special efforts to cover up the medical neglect. So sometimes doctor may take the money from other people and he tries to cover up the medical negligence and also intentions in a wrong way. So if the doctor is the main medical evidence, so if he says wrong, that innocent peoples are always affected. So the history of this forensic medicine is, it is nothing but the medicine and law are combined by the bonds of religion, superstition, and magic. So the history is Charaka Samhita is a Indian history that gave a code regarding training duties, giving description of various poisons and treatments. And Manu in Manu Smriti included the punishment to sexual offenses, recognized mental incapacity due to intoxication, illness, and age. And Arthra Shastra of Kautilya gave the penal laws for negligence about examination of dead bodies in unnatural deaths and also abortion and sexual offenses. And in Summer Babylon of Egypt, they said the law medicine problems are found in written records of Egypt. And the Chinese Materia Medica of 3000 BC gave the information on the poisons. And Imhotep, Grand Vizier, Chief Justice and Chief Physician of King Djoser of Egypt, enacted the rules of medical practice and they are included under the laws now. So the code of Hammurabi, the king of Babylon, the oldest known medical code. The code of Hammurabi is the oldest medical code. And the Rig Veda, Atharva Veda mentioned about the crimes like killing embryo and drunkenness and other punishments. So, and Paul Jechias, father of the legal medicine. So, father of forensic psychiatry is the Paul Jechias. It is important. Father of legal medicine as well as the father of the forensic psychiatry. Scientists said the Hippocrates, the father of the Western medicine, he actually discussed the lethality of the wounds. And also Rabinke and Cort, responsible for the implementing in the Rabin's actually of Rabisi and Cort is responsible for implanting the Jewish laws. And the Sushruta, the father of Indian surgery, he treatised the Sushruta Samhita, which is dealing with the various medico-legal problems. And also duties of the physicians are different, and also wounds and fractures were classified, and the poisons and snakes were classified, and the treatment is also prescribed. The modes of administration of poisons is also was also described there. And the Justinian code of the Roman emperor, he practiced the medicine and he regulated the practice of medicine and injury, and also established the function of medical expert for the legal procedures. And the first medico-legal autopsy is done in Bolgona by Bartolomeo di Vargignana. So the first medico-legal autopsy by the Bartolomeo di Vargignana. And the manual was prepared in aiding the investigation of death in China. And next, George Bishop of Bamberg proclaimed a penal code in 1507 where the medical evidence was necessity in certain cases. And also the Caroline code in Germany by Emperor Charles, with expert in the medical testimony, became a requirement rather than an opinion to give opinions in case of murders, wounding and poisoning, hanging, drowning and infanticide and abortion. And next, coming to the types of homicides were not punishable under certain conditions, which was offender who was deprived as understanding. The first book on the forensic medicine was by Italian physician, that is the Fortunato Fedeli. And the questions medicologist was given by father of forensic, that is Paulus Jechias. And the 7 volumes are written and additional 2 volumes are written at the Amsterdam. And next, coming to the field of pathological mental states, amenorrheas and exclusive competence mental disorders in mind, the legal issue at that time. And as the autopsies in the medico-legal cases began to generally practiced, Orfila, the professor of chemistry and the legal medicine at the Paris, he introduced the precise chemical methods into toxicology. And he is also known as the founder of modern toxicology. Who is that founder? That is Orfila. And the criminal responsibilities of insane persons was established in England, that is in McNaughton's case. So these are some more extra scientists here.